The United Nations Secretary General's study on the violence against children, published in 2006, calls for an end to the justification of violence against children, whether accepted as tradition or disguised as discipline. It further goes on to ask states to prohibit all forms of violent practices, including corporal punishment. UNICEF's Caribbean representative says it's an issue the organization is trying to tackle around the world.
There is evidence, study after study has shown that children who are not raised to have self-discipline, to know the boundaries of what's right and wrong, but who are forced into a form of violence to show what is right and wrong, in later in life and within their childhood, show acts of violence. And it's showing that you want a certain result, you must do it through a violent mean. And that's putting the children on a path of greater violence.
UNICEF says violence against children remains legal throughout much of the world, although some countries have moved to ban or limit violence in the home, at school, in care institutions, or in the penal system. But the UN agency says in order to legally ban all forms of violence against children, including violent discipline, countries must explicitly prohibit the practice and also eliminate any provisions that may allow its continued use. St. Lucia's Minister for Health, Human Affairs, Gender Affairs and Family Relations admits that dealing with issues involving the protection of the rights of children pose their own set of challenges.
We are grappling with a number of social issues confronting children and families. Chief about it all looks at child abuse in all its forms. And of course, this is something that is very sensitive and very troubling for us in the region, in particular in St. Lucia. We look at education, healthcare for children and families. And of course, we can't take the children in isolation. We have to look at parents. And also, as we look at issues of how do we parent, how do we have good parents? And so we need to give young parents in particular the knowledge and the skill that they can raise their children to be productive, to be happy and healthy.
Organizers of the midterm review of programs for the development of children being held here in St. Lucia have acknowledged that these gains made in protecting children are under threat. This, they say, is due to the persistent economic challenges and vulnerabilities to other external social and environmental shocks facing the small island development states of the Eastern Caribbean area. For the DBS News World, I am Alex Bousquet.